Could quantum computing be even bigger than AI? Here to talk about one stock that's really making headlines in the field of quantum computing is MarketBeat analyst Thomas Hughes. Thomas, this is a stock chart I haven't seen in a while. There is so much volatility going on with this company.
Yeah, this is a pretty wicked chart to look at. I think that stock price is up like a couple thousand percent in the last part of 2024. And now it's down pretty sharply.
We're talking about Rigetti here. This is a name. There's lots of different quantum computing stocks out there, but Rigetti has really gained some notoriety, at least in the last few months. Why is that?
It's one of the industry leading quantum computing manufacturers. It's made some advances over the last year and has some product launches due out this year that kind of cement its place as an industry leader. And so those are going to be catalysts for the stock price over the next couple of months.
Let's dive into that stock price. Where was this stock at even just 3 months ago?
Late October, it was trading about, well, under a dollar, and then it rocketed up to the $20 level, and today it's down around $11.50. So that's a pretty wild swing. A lot of that's driven by speculators, a little bit of FOMO, fear of missing out, no small amount of short covering, and also shorts repositioning.
Well, let's talk about some of that FOMO a little bit. I think a lot of investors are interested in quantum computing right now because they want to get on the front end of what could be or is expected to be a really revolutionary technology coming on the field. We've seen what artificial intelligence has done in the last couple of years, and the investors who got in on that early are doing really well today. And so I think that's what they're looking to see is quantum computing that next revolutionary tech that's really going to pay off for investors?
Quantum computing could be that next revolutionary tech. The way that it works, it's able to handle much larger data sets and do more complex processes than traditional computing, but it's still really a long way off before it's going to be viable. And that's part of what the volatility is about right now. The company's advances and advances by Google with its Willow system suggest that the market is advancing pretty rapidly and that we'll have viable quantum computing sooner rather than later. But the reality is that we may have viable quantum computing later rather than sooner. And so it's hard to say just exactly when this company is going to start making money. It could be quite a few years. 10, 15, 20 years, depending on who you ask.
Yeah, that's a good point, that with any kind of new technology, the question really is, when is that breakthrough going to come that takes this to that commercial level? Are we anywhere close with any kind of commercialization of quantum computing?
Rigetti has some processors that they sell. They also provide quantum computing as a service. Some of their services are going to be available across Microsoft and Amazon Web Services pretty soon. But what quantum computing is able to do right now, it's more of a novelty, a high error rate novelty, than it is a viable computing service.
Let's talk about what it's going to take to get this kind of a product to commercialization. And that's a lot of research and development. And all of that, of course, costs a lot of money. Talk about the cash flow for this company a little bit.
Well, right now they're burning cash. The company says that it's well capitalized. That did come at a cost. They had to sell some shares to make that happen. According to them, they've got enough cash to make it through to the end. But that takes you right to that questionable line. Where is the end? Is it going to be sooner or later? So the company says sooner, but industry insiders like NVIDIA CEO Jensen Huang and Meta Platform CEO Mark Zuckerberg both think it's going to be later. And so that raises the real question of how much capital do they still need? It looks like in the scenario that is unfolding, they're probably going to need to raise more capital within 8 years or so. And that's well before they're expected to reach commercial viability.
So Thomas, is it possible that companies like Rigetti that are really on the cutting edge of quantum computing maybe won't even get there entirely? They'll be trying to solve this problem that never really has a resolution.
Oh, that's entirely possible. There's no guarantee that they're ever going to have a viable quantum computing solution. It's possible somebody else could reach the end goal before they do. So those are both very good questions and part of why the stock is so volatile right now. It's just part of the concern that investors have is what's going to happen. The future is very uncertain.
Let's talk about that uncertainty and what it means for investors. First off, for those short sellers out there, I feel like this is exactly what they're looking for.
I would say yes, there's a threat of shareholder dilution. The company's burning capital. There's a long, long runway to reaching profitability. There's plenty of time for the bull market to become disinterested. And in that scenario, this stock could go right back to under a dollar.
So what does that mean for investors who might be looking at this more long-term rather than trying to ride the volatility? Maybe they really do believe in the idea of quantum computing and they want to get in on that investment early. What advice do you have for them?
I think that this is a viable speculation on technology, but I would absolutely not be chasing prices higher. I would pick a nice low price point at some, you know, clear technical level, set a limit order and let the market come to me. I mean, don't chase those prices, because you'll end up getting whipsawed out of the market and losing money.
Some very good advice there. Now, the other question is, why Rigetti? There's quite a few players in quantum computing. What would make you pick Rigetti over some of the competition?
Well, right now, it's just because of their advances and the upcoming product launches. They're the first company to come out with a multi-chip processor. They've got some new processors coming out this year, including new cloud services over Azure and Amazon Web Services. So that really just sets it apart from other quantum computing stocks right now.
So Thomas, quantum computing, it really started to make headlines at the end of 2024. And now a lot of investors are curious about this, really thinking about, like you mentioned before, FOMO, wanting to get in early if this is the next big thing. But I feel like we've seen a recent case study back in 2021, 2022, when AI was really just all these new companies were coming out and we saw a lot of really big investment in those companies. Is that a good comparison of what might be happening with quantum computing right now?
I think it is. There certainly have been some good advances in the technology. Those advances have, you know, kind of highlighted the potential for viability and for profits, and that's got the market interested. So what we've seen right now is just the first influx of money. People are trying to get in and get positioned, trying to figure out some price discovery. What are the stocks really worth? We're going to see some stocks continue to move higher. Some are going to fall to the wayside. It's just the way things go.
Yeah, we've seen it on the market time and time again, and we'll continue to watch quantum computing here on MarketBeat to see where this sector might go and when that next big breakthrough might actually happen. If you are more of a growth investor looking for stocks with some big upside potential, check out our latest free report, The Next 7 Blockbuster Stocks for Growth Investors. You can scan the QR code or click the link in the description to read that full report on marketbeat.com. All right, Thomas, thank you so much for the analysis on Rigetti and quantum computing today. Let us know what you think about quantum computing and if you're one of the early investors getting in on this sector. Thanks again for joining us. As always, happy investing.